Prime Minister of Pakistan and His Excellency the President of Uzbekistan met in the SU summit in Astana in July this year. The Foreign Minister of Uzbekistan was one of the first foreign ministers to visit Pakistan after the general elections there. We are also looking forward for the participation of the Prime Minister of Uzbekistan in the SU Council of Heads of Government to be held in Islamabad this month. In the two countries, I have also been growing. Pakistan-Uzbekistan Transit Trade Agreement and the Preferential Trade Agreement have been operationalized. And we have seen a significant and a very handsome increase, annual increase in the trade, bilateral trade of the two sides. Our aim is to take Pakistan-Uzbekistan bilateral trades to the level of $1 billion. As part of trade promotion, Pakistan held the Pakistan single country exhibition called titled Made in Pakistan this June. This was the first ever single country exhibition of Pakistan in Central Asia and of any country in Uzbekistan. More than 80 companies from Pakistan participated in this exhibition and multiple sectors including textiles, pharmaceuticals, surgical instruments, food and agricultural products. The three-day exhibition was visited by about 150,000 people and about over 300 business-to-business meetings were held on this occasion. Pakistan offers which included entrepreneurs, shipping companies, and market analysts and general public. The most economic route to Uzbekistan, in fact, for entire Central Asia for access to sea. Pakistan has three operational ports to which are able to cater to the needs of entire region and Uzbekistan due to its central location in the region. Uzbekistan is an important partner and hub for Pakistan in this connectivity endeavor. Last year, about 1 million ton cargo was shipped between Pakistan and Uzbekistan through Afghanistan. Leading cargo companies of Pakistan, such as National Logistics Sales and TCS, have since last year started TIR operations which are providing quality and hassle-free transport services. This has further reduced the time and cost of cargo transportation from Pakistan to Central Asia. Now we can have a consignment from Karachi to Tirmiz in less than 12 days. We are working to further reduce this time. When we talk of connectivity, very important aspect of our long-term vision in this phenomenon includes the Trans-Afghanistan Railway, which when completed would reduce the cargo transportation time within a week. It is a route connecting Uzbekistan, Central Asia to Pakistan through Afghanistan. In this context, the three countries have finalized the route and are now working on the final feasibility study of the project. The embassy, along with the authorities of Pakistan, hosted a logistics forum. It was widely attended by the representative of logistic firms, shipping agents, trade and investment representatives, industry experts and business owners. The forum focused on Pakistan's strategic location, which connects South Asia, Central Asia, Middle East and serves as the gateway to the Arabian Sea and major shipping routes. The two countries, Pakistan and Uzbekistan, are also closely working with each other on the regional peace and stability, especially counter-terrorism. Similarly, the two sides are also collaborating in the various fields of defense cooperation. A valuable asset in Pakistan-Uzbekistan bilateral relations. In order to facilitate people-to-people contact, we are pleased to share that very recently, Pakistan introduced a new liberalized visa regime for Uzbekistan citizens where they can obtain online 90-day multiple entry visa for Pakistan without fee. The processing time has also been reduced to facilitate tourism and business exchanges between the two countries. To promote people-to-people contact, we are also working to establish contacts between the academia think tanks of the two countries. In this regard, we had the pleasure of decorating Professor Dr. Mohayyo Abdurrahmanova, a notable Urdu scholar of Uzbekistan, with Tamghai Imtiaz, or the Medal of Distinction, on behalf of the President of Islamic Republic of Pakistan, for her services. People like Dr. Mohayyo are an asset in promoting our centuries-old cultural links. Similarly, the embassy regularly hold events of public diplomacy where we try to bring the two bring Pakistani representative and Uzbek partners to celebrate the commonalities of our culture. Last but not least, I would like to share with you that esteemed the media representative like yourselves are an important part of promoting people-to-people relations. And we would very much like all of you to be our partners in furthering this friendship, which is an asset for both our people. Now I would like to invite any questions, any discussion that you would like to have. Thank you. I will say that you see, you being a pillar and a part of the media and being a media representative are a very important element of our efforts to build up a positive narrative. Now coming to security issues, first of all, let me just say that, perhaps media picks up, which is extraordinary. So Pakistan is a country of like 240 million people in a million square kilometers. So maybe one odd event in that gets more projection than others. Similarly, but there are 240 million people with a growing economy, and so they are all living, and there is a lot more that Pakistan has to offer, that Afghanistan has to offer, and that Uzbekistan has to offer. Now, how you can be, as I said, you need to be our partner. How you can be our partner is that we need to work together to bring out the reality. I'm not saying that we say a particular narrative, but we just project the reality as it is. And the reality is that, there were times when we were talking about connectivity and trade, we could not have proper trade and connectivity via Afghanistan. Now things are much better. So this is a reality that perhaps is not fully appreciated, and this has opened opportunities for us. Moreover, both Pakistan and Uzbekistan are working for regional stability and regional prosperity. What we want is that all the countries in the region become integrated into our economic development and our efforts and become our partners in peace and prosperity. So we are both working on it. We are both, Pakistan and Uzbekistan, also understand that without addressing the menace of terrorism, we cannot have economic progress. And we are very methodically and closely cooperating with each other, as I said in my remarks as well. So you also have a very important role to play. Show the reality, show how things really are. Thank you. And our aim, both sides, both Pakistan, and this is the main focus of our relationship, that we increase the trade relations between the two sides. And as I mentioned that Pakistan held the single country exhibition, so that was one of very important elements to promote and make the business people come together, because it is up to them to promote business. And they know how to do their job. Our job is just to get them together, and that's what we tried to do. And as I said, there were thousands of business-to-business meetings, and there were 150,000 footfall total. So we had a very impressive show. Now we are hoping, and we are working with our Uzbek partners to have a similar trade single country exhibition in Pakistan as well. We are also trying to engage, apart from these big events, the business communities of the two. And that is why, let me share with you that it was last year that Pakistan opened the business and trade and investment section in the embassy. Before that, we were not here. And Mr. Atallah was our first, is our first trade and investment counselor. So this is very much a focus. And to share further, like I would like to invite Mr. Atallah. He would share with you the figures and further things.
So, besides those steps, I would mention that we are working on the expansion of the preferential trade agreement between the two countries. We are adding more products, and both the governments have agreed that we will start the negotiations soon. Secondly, different exhibitions are taking place in Uzbekistan and in Pakistan. The business community are also participating in those exhibitions, like 8 companies from Uzbekistan visited Lahore in this January, and 14 companies from Uzbekistan participated in the food and agriculture exhibition in Karachi. Right now, when we are speaking, 2 big companies are here in Uzbekistan, one from the textile sector and another from the steel manufacturing sector. So a lot of activities are taking place in order to reach the target which has been set by the leadership of both the countries. Regarding the figures, I would mention here the figures which have been issued by the Statistics Agency of Uzbekistan. And as per their statistics, the bilateral trade has reached to 418 billion during the 2023, and it is increasing every year. Like if we go back 3-4 years back, so it was not touching even 150 billion. And now it has reached to 418 billion. So there is an increasing increase in the